Welcome to another episode of Reaper's Music Reviews. On this episode, we will review Filipino rock band Kjwan. And we will review their second album, Two Step Marv. So if you're excited to watch this video, then don't forget to subscribe to my channel and follow my social media account. Kjwan is a Filipino hard rock band formed in 2003. The band composed of Marc Abaya on vocals, Kelly Mangahas on bass, Jorel Corpus on guitar, Jaehoon Balbuena on drums, and Boogie Romero on guitars. Two Step to Marv is the second album by Kjwan. It was released through Barnyard Music Philippines in 2006. The band won Favorite Indie Artist in the Mixed Music Awards. Their video Pintura nabbed Favorite Guest Appearance featuring Chinchin Gutierrez. They also got nominated in the 6 categories in the 2007 New Rock Awards for Artist of the Year, Best Live Act, Album of the Year, Producer of the Year, Vocalist of the Year, and the Guitarist of the Year. Two Step to Marv was a massive success for the bands as they cemented themselves with the releases that included Pintura, Sa Ilalim, Shai, Invitation, and One Look. One of their biggest breakthrough was winning the grand prize in the Asian and Philippine leg in Icon ASEAN competition, held in Putrajaya, Malaysia, and watched by hundreds of thousands all over the region. Their performance made an impact to the Asian music community. Kjwan beat 30 other bands from both the Philippines and Southeast Asia. Let's start the album review. And my top favorite tracks in this album, those are Pintura, Sa Ilalim, and Invitation. On the song Pintura, this is the coolest song in the album. And what the songs makes really cool is I love the riffs and the chugging of the drums. It's very good to the ears, especially on the intro parts doon sa Tererenenenenenenenenenenenen. Tapos intro siya, tapos biglang Tererenenenenenenenenenen. Grabe yung angas niya. Marc Abaya's voice fits well on the song and may attitude at angas siya every time he sings the song. And if I remembered, I discovered this song when he sang this song on Mix Live. And as far as I remember, it was in summer 2006. High school pa ako noon eh. And his appearance on that sa Mix Live is like a demon singing. Nung nakita ko nga siya, napaisip ako, sino tong demonyo yung kumakanta sa harapan ng TV? Pero nung nakita ko siya talaga, naastiga na talaga ako sa kanya. And that's the time that I discovered the band, and the rest, it was history. And going back to the song, I love the chorus part, especially when Marc's execute, "Sino ka ba? Ano ang iyong lihim?" Kakaiba yung balance nung bigat and soft singing sa pag-execute niya dun sa chorus. It's amazing. On Invitation, all of the instruments are really great. Lahat sila may kanya-kanyang part at very nice to listen. And well played yung mga instruments and you would enjoy the melody. The drums outstands the most. Maganda yung sulod-sulod na atake ng drums and very soothing siya. Then followed by the bass. Kelly's bass gives life on the song. His bass skills brings out the goodness of the song and I love the bridge parts. All out lahat ng instruments and it gives my ear satisfied. On the song Sa Ilalim, I love the riffs so much. It's just right and It's not heavy nor light. And this song, tama lang naman yung atake and very catchy siya. And it steals your mind. Mark's vocal did well and he have a remarkable voice on the chorus. And in fact, nakaka-LSS tong kanta na to. My honorable mentions, those are Daan and One Look. On Daan, I love the song so much and the tune has a similarities on the song Invitation but with the heavier riffs. And I love the intro parts, all out yung bigat niya at maganda yung execution ng pagkanta ni Marc Abaya sa kanta na to. And at the same time, yung drums dito, nakaka-irgasm siya, maganda yung bigat at talagang very remarkable. On One Look, this track has a different vibe against on their other songs in this album. And it's very relaxing, very chill yung voice ni Marc Abaya. And you will see that Kjwan has presenting a different side of the band. His favorite songs in the album, those are Slow Shutter, Can't Do That, and Two Step Marv. On the song Slow Shutter, what the songs I don't like the most is sobrang bagal ng kanta. Boring pakinggan ang song and has repeated melodies. This track is kinda more on filler track and I don't like the rap parts on the last parts as well as the drums na nung sa pinaka very last. It's very annoying kapag pinakikinggan mo siya. Every time I play this song, I intend not to finish the entire song, especially dun sa rap parts at saka dun sa drum parts. Talagang parang nagsasayang lang ako ng oras. On the song Can't Do That, this song has a jazz vibe and iba-iba yung transition ng song. To be honest, hindi ko masakyan talaga yung kanta. And hindi ko alam kung saan ang direction ng kanta na to. And I could say that Mark's voice doesn't really fit on this song. Para sa akin, merong taong babagay dito sa kanta na to and for me, hindi talaga sabihin sa kanta na to. On Two Step Marv, I don't like this song same as with Slow Shutter. And in fact, this song and Slow Shutter are the bottom group in this album. The reason why I don't like this song is that annoying yung high pitch ng guitar. And the first time I listened this, tinanggal ko agad yung headset ko kasi masakit sa tenga yung high pitch ng tone ng guitars at hindi ko talaga ma-appreciate yung kanta. Kahit na maganda naman yung execution ng kanta pero dun sa pitch ng guitar talaga ako na annoy. I could say Kjwan keep their angas factor and being sophisticated in their song writing. And they being constant of what they're doing. Comparing on the first album, this album has more on chill songs and they did more experimentation and incorporate different genres. They did it well on some of their songs, but some I don't like the result. On the songs Can't Do That and Slow Shutter, I don't know where the band's direction going. Iba-iba yung atake at yung melody ng kanta, kaya naboboard akong pakinggan ng mga kantang to. One thing is that these songs are not fit on Mark's voice and I could say that they should look on the better vocalist na pwedeng kumanta dun sa mga kanta na to. Musically wise, they executed the song and showed their talents very well. Jorel and Boogie's guitars are the stars on this album. The delivery of the shreds and riffs is very catchy and gives the coolness of the song. Jaehoon's guitars and Kelly's bass are also good and supports the guitars very well. Marc Abaya sang good, but some of the songs didn't fit well on his voice and as I mentioned earlier. I could say Kjwan did well in this album and I could say that they keep their originality and didn't go to the mainstream sound. Now, for the verdict, I could rate this album as 3.5 out of 5. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this episode and let me know your thoughts for Kjwan's two-step Marv album. Just comment it down below. And if you have an album suggestions for a review, just don't hesitate to comment it down below and I'm sure we entertain it. It's time for the shoutouts, and I would like to thank all of you for your relentless support. And please keep watching my videos. Marami pa tayo mga contents na ilalabas in the future time, okay? So, let's start with shout out to Sakana Band. This is requested by my friend Jerry Balading. So, kaway dito sa banda na to. Shout out sa inyo. And please do check them out their Facebook fan page, okay? Shout out to Cynthia Gerson. Cynthia, thank you so much for your support and please do support her YouTube channel. I also put the links in the description, so please check her out, okay? And then, Teddy Chodosho, thank you so much for your support. Lagi mo ako sinusuportahan dito sa video ko. And please do check his YouTube channel. Ang gaganda ng mga contents sa mga guitar solos. Kahit ako namamangha ako sa mga guitar solos niya. So, please support him. Malaki potential dito, okay? So again, salamat sa inyong suporta. And again, this is Ian from the Reaper Rocker Vlog signing off. We'll see you again in the most episode. Rock on, Pilipinas!